So you might know if you, in version 19, you go into settings and then media, we have a cleanup media feature. That's not new. What was the case is that when you clicked on it, if they found disconnected media, then it would just move it to the trash can or recycle bin. That's the way it was. But, presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, the updated media manager in ProPresenter 19. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever just realized you had a bunch of media in ProPresenter that you weren't using and you just wanted to clean it out, go ahead, tell me about it in the comments below. Also, like and subscribe while you're at it. Share this with someone who might find it interesting as well. So, I kind of made this video already. But I made it when ProPresenter version 19 was in beta. And actually, right after it was announced. Well, Renewed Vision listened to some concerns that some of those of us who were beta testers had, and they tweaked something. So I thought that we would go into my computer and take a look at what they tweaked and maybe a use case for it that you might not have considered. So let's head over. Okay, so you might know, if you, in version 19, you go into settings and then media, we have a cleanup media feature. That's not new. What was the case is that when you clicked on it, if they found disconnected media, then it would just move it to the trash can or recycle bin. That's the way it was. But they've added a feature. So, and I'll tell you that immediately you might think, well, that's no big deal. But let me just tell you the implications of it. So let's, real quick, I'm going to maybe get rid of some stuff here. Like, let's get rid of this. And let's get rid of this. And I'm going to get rid of this. And let's see here. I've got all this, so let's just delete this. Okay. I think that might just do it. Let's try it. Let's see what else we can do here. Actually, I'm going to delete this all together, and let's go into sermon here, and I'm just going to delete all my sermons, and I'm also going to delete these. Okay, by the way, notice this. If you're in version 19 and you have that, don't worry about it. Go ahead and let it sit for a while, restart it, and that should go away. If after you've let it sit for a while, you've restarted a couple of times, if it doesn't go away, reach out to support. But that is something that some people are freaking out about, and sometimes initial startups will give you thumbnails that look like this. It could be that these are just missing in my case. But anyway, let's go back here into media. So settings, then media, and try it one more time. We'll be right back. Okay, so this is it. Right here. Before, we would just move to trash. You didn't have this option. But move to folder is what I want to point out. So if I click move to folder, it's going to navigate to a folder. Well, what I'm going to suggest that you might want to do is click new folder and give it today's date. Personally, I like to do the last two of the year, then the two of the month, and the two of the date. So in this case, I'm recording this on July 22nd, so of 2025, so that'll be 250722. Okay, now let's call that media clean up. So what I could do is about once a month, I could go through and do that, put the date there every time in this new folder, and then when I select it, ProPresenter is going to clean up the media. We can see the status up here, but it's actually already done it, I think. So, yep. So it says idle here. But if I were to go to that folder, so let me go into Finder here. In Windows, it'll be in Windows Explorer. And let's find that. I think that was under Paul Clifford. Yep, here it is, right here. So now I find these two right here that I can, having just cleaned that up, I can look at those and say, okay, do I want to delete them all together or do I want to save them? If I want to save them, I might turn this into an archive folder, or if I want to delete them all together, I might just delete the entire folder. So that's the little change that they made in ProPresenter 19 that I think is going to be huge when it comes to just all the things that we can do. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/ProQuick. Give me your name and email address and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford with TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.